Namibia's education sector leaves much to be desired. Following last year's teacher strike, the grade 10 and 12 failures, one can truly say that this sector is just in turmoil. And it is no surprise that those who can afford to do so send their children out of the country for education. We spoke to the DTA's Elma Dienda, the Secretary of Education. So, Ms. Dienda, this culture in Namibia of students and teachers having affairs, let alone the husband of a school principal being able to tell a girl to whip out her boobs and let him fondle them and thereby determine her pregnancy status. I mean, what do you make of that?
First of all, the question that comes to my mind was that where was a life skill teacher of that specific school? Because I know that every school was supposed to appoint a life skill teacher to deal with matter like this. So why did the teacher not first go to the life skill teacher and ask the life skill teacher to take up this matter? And then second question which came to my mind was the issue of the school principal, who is the wife of the teacher. So it seems that women, we are being appointed into positions, but we are being remote controlled by somebody out of our house, which for me is not good. I cannot be a member of parliament and then my husband will decide it in my house what will I say and what I will not say, what I will do and what I will not do. So this was an unfortunate situation which I could not believe. And I say I was one of the front runners for 50-50, gender equality, women now and whatever. This is how I was dancing every time for this 50-50. And now I'm so disappointed if we cannot take a stand as women and say, no. I will handle this matter in a mature way because I am the appointing officer responsible for the situation. And that I didn't see. Lack of assertiveness, boldness from the school principal.
And I mean, what kind of woman? You wake up next to your husband every morning, he's out there with his private personal pregnancy test that he's pulling out every day, and you drive to work. What do you talk about? How do you act like nothing happened?
And what does he say? It's about our relationship as husband and wife.
Exactly.
So if we can go out there and
fondle youth.
Other women, what about me? So does he say that I am not good enough? Or what is actually the message that this husband gave to us? So there are so many things. And the permanent secretary, Ms. Annette Steenkamp, did not really answer the questions of the public when she was interviewed on Good Morning Namibia. Because for her to say that this matter was not brought to under their attention as fast or soon as possible, that was also not good enough, because I know this matter is coming from a long time on, that people were sending SMSs about what was happening. Why did her office wait? Why did they wait for an official report coming from the school? It was action that was needed, not a report. For her to wait for a report. So why didn't they take action in the first place? So I don't know. I feel that in this case, and I know that this is not the first case, we know that there are a lot of relationships between teachers and learners, but these things is just a taboo subject. People don't want to talk about it. I don't know what is the reason. I don't know why parents allow their children to be involved in this relationship. And if they don't allow them, if they found out about it, what are they doing? This is my question.
And what is happening in this country? If this is a culture, you know, that just seems to be permeating all levels of society. Almost last year we had the schoolgirl who got murdered by the teacher. You remember that situation where the teacher...
Yes,
the two sisters, that is a child. Even these men, like, you know, how do you look at yourselves? They are fathers raping their children consistently year after year after year, and Mr. Shingo gets a fine. The justice system gives him a fine, and then later he decides, okay, let me resign, ma. It's getting too hot. What is that?
Now, you know, in 2015, we passed this children's protection bill in parliament, which is now an act. And it is so clearly stated in that act, there will be a children's advocate. Now I came up and I asked myself, children's advocate doing what? You are reading newspapers, you read about all these things, and you are still quiet. So why did we bring in a law just for children to be protected? And that person, I don't know who is the person anymore, and that person is doing nothing. So are we doing justice to our systems? Are we just passing laws in Parliament for the fun of passing laws? Sorry, but nothing is happening. So I'm really asking myself, even the Public Service Act, we are not implementing our laws. We don't do it. It's just, and then we are claiming, oh, Namibians have the best laws. It's fine, it's there, but it's just there.
It's not in practice.
So what are you saying about ourselves? Are we just a country who are passing laws with no implementation of those laws? So I hope that this will be a wake-up call. That all school principals, and this is where I came in with monitoring and evaluation, that system is not in place. Our principals are not heading their schools. Our principals does not know what is happening in the school systems. Our school board members, most of them did not receive training. Our school board members are just there to update their CVs, which is wrong. If you go to any school now and ask one school board member the guidelines for school board members, you will only find maybe two of them having it. Most of the school board members doesn't know it. They never open that book. They don't even know that there's a booklet to guide them on how to operate the schools. So things are happening. The school board members are not even aware of these things. So why are they not involved? So somewhere I failed to understand our systems, and I said it previously, I will say it again. I was a chairperson of a school board for two consecutive terms, and I can tell you now, every time I will make sure that school board members will receive training, and I will ask them, do you know why you are here? Do you know that you are there to make sure that the rules of the school will be implemented? But they're just sitting there, remote control by management. If management have made the decision, the school board members will not even ask, query them. They will just agree.
Now, Namibians are very apathetic as a society. We really, I don't know whether it's people just lost desire, you know, or the flame has died or what. But literally, Namibians are not doing anything about everything they complain about amongst themselves and communities at home. Nothing's done on a larger scale. Why do you think that is, and what do you think we should do in cases especially like this to make sure our voices are heard, to protect children, to protect young women, and to absolutely reduce the scourge of GBV in the country, because we are really like endangered species out here?
I think there's this issue comes in with people are afraid to speak out. We have freedom of speech in our country, but most of our people are cowards. They don't want to talk about issues. No, if I will talk about this issue, I might lose my job. So what? If that is a matter, let it be. Because our forefathers were not afraid for fighting for the right things. So why must I be afraid? Why must I become a coward? So I want people to walk out of their comfort zones and start tackling issues which are of nation concern. If a principal have done something wrong, let's talk about it. If the president have done something wrong, let's talk about it. We cannot be afraid of intimidation and victimization. I will never keep quiet. That day I will be quiet will be when I'm dead. But for now, I will speak my mind. I'm not here on this earth to be loved by anybody, because as long as Jesus Christ is loving me, who is my creator, I'm very much happy and very much satisfied. But I will not be silent just because my position. If I speak too much, I will be removed from Parliament. Remove me. I can do other things. I don't care. But people must stop being hypocrites. I don't have time. I don't have respect for them. You will find the school principal who will say, no, you see, I don't want to be involved in this office politics. I have 5 years before I will retire. So you want to mess up the future of my child because you want to retire in peace and with a nice salary package, and you're messing up my child's education. No, we don't need those principals. Let them get out, and let's bring in new people who can take our schools forward.
Our producer, Joseph Shafeni, took to Jan Moore School today, where he found out from students how they feel about this situation.
A fine only.
Yes.
A fine only. Yes, the government must take stronger things, because, I mean, like, if it was your child, what would you do? Only a fine of $300 that they got paid on the 20th. They already paid, then they're off teaching again, touching other girls' things. No, it is wrong. The government must have strict laws. That's why they are the government. They're not sitting there to just do nonsense. They're supposed to take care of us because we are their future leaders. And we are supposed to be treated as future leaders, not by touching where we don't want to be touched.
You know, it's a big problem because the students are older than the learners. And you all saw what happened last time, that the student was dating a teacher. And then a student was murdered with a sister. So I don't think it's a good thing. I think it's a very bad thing.
I think it's a bad way for teachers and children to interact because teachers aren't supposed to have a sexual relationship with children. Teachers are mostly just there for teaching the children.
I think that it's very wrong that he did that. And I think that us as a community, we should be fighting against that. Because in this country, it's like rape is a very, very big problem. And students and teachers shouldn't have relationships because not only is it wrong, but then the kids are also underage.
Teachers having relationship with kids is not right in schools because they do other things and they only do favoritism on those kids that have relationships with. And what we can do for them, you can take action as in going to the Women and Child Abuse Center, talking to some teachers and just, like, it feels uncomfortable, a teacher looking at a girl's butt or something like that, which is not right. So I think we should take action by going to the police or to the principal or something and report it, and the teachers, something has to happen to the teacher.
Yeah, we've been told to go to Women and Child, the police, or even your own teacher or your mom, even a friend that you trust or someone.
It's starting to scare us and a lot of other children out there, because there are those that are younger than us, primary schools, who obviously cannot defend themselves or have people to stand up for them when things like this happen to them, and it's very wrong.